Today I'm going to be showing you the best hidden features for the brand new iPhone 11 and iPhone 11 Pro. Let's take a look. A great part of your new iPhone 11 are the three impressive cameras on the back. But what you may not know is you can actually quickly take video just by pressing and holding the camera button. So normally you just take a picture like so. But if you press and hold and drag to the right, you can actually automatically start taking a video like so. And then you just have to hit the stop button and you've automatically recorded a video. This is very easy. Let's say you whip out your camera, you wanna take a quick video, instead of swiping through, trying to find the right spot, all you have to do is press, bring over to the right, and you can see that you're able to start taking a video right away. This is a great hidden feature you may not have known about in order to quickly take videos right here on your iPhone 11. Now, of course, and this isn't really as hidden, but these are more tips, be sure to switch back and forth between the different cameras. You can do that right here. You can also make it a wider angle as well, or be able to see the full screen by going over here. Instead of 4:3, you can actually have it be a full 16:9 image. Look at that. You can see that actually takes up the full screen just like so. But again, the big hidden feature that I wanted to show you here was pressing, dragging over to the right in order to start recording video automatically. It's that easy. So one of the first hidden features that I want to show you has to do with the new dark mode on the iPhone 11 and iPhone 11 Pro. Now you probably already do know about the dark mode, so you can swipe down into the control center, press and hold on brightness, activate the dark mode. So you can see here that it changes everything darker. That way it's easier on the eyes, easier to see. You can see that all the whites turn black, and you can see that it's a lot easier to read at night. This is going to be a great way to make sure that your eyes adjust to the brightness. But what you may not know is you can actually have dark mode automatically activate when it gets dark and night outside. And that's what we're gonna show you how to do. And later in this video, we're gonna show you how to get the secret dark mode button right here in the control center. That way you don't have to press and hold on brightness, click dark mode again. We're actually gonna show you how you can get a dark mode button. We'll show you that later on in this video. But the first hidden feature that we wanna show you is how to set this on a timer so that you can actually have dark mode activate when it gets dark outside. So first, open up your settings app, and then you're gonna scroll down until you see display and brightness right here. So you can see that you have light and dark, and this is one of the areas that you'd normally change this in, crack back and forth from light to dark. Obviously you can also go through in the control center as well. But what you may not know is you can actually have this be automatic. So by default, automatic is turned off. But let's say you want it to be light when it's light outside and dark, obviously, when it turns to night. What you could do is click this automatic, and then you can see the options are light until sunset. So what that means is that during the day, it will be the light background, and then at night, it will automatically change to the dark background. It'll do this every day, and it's not even at a set time. It will automatically detect when sunrise and sunset is, and change your iPhone accordingly. It's incredible. Now, if you click on the options, you can also set up a custom schedule for this as well, where you can change the exact time when this happens, but I like to keep it sunset to sunrise, so it goes back and forth between light and dark. Now, down here as well, you can see that we do have True Tone, but you can also turn Night Shift on and off. Now, Night Shift allows you to have warmer colors. It gets rid of some of those harsher blue lights. Now, my camera is adjusting automatically, so you might not be able to see that as well, but you can actually make the color temperature more warm, and you can also have this be scheduled as well. So you can have this turn on at night as well. That way, you have less of that blue light that's gonna keep you up. That's another great feature in here as well. Now, a little bit later on, we're gonna show you how to add that dark mode button to the control center. But first, I wanna show you another great hidden feature that's actually going to allow you to block spam calls, robocalls, voice messages. I'm sure your phone is being blown up, I know mine is, just by getting constant messages from telemarketers, scammers, spammers, people just calling you all the time. Well, on your iPhone, running iOS 13, on your iPhone 11, you can actually automatically block unknown callers. This is an incredible feature. Now, it's not on by default, so we're gonna show you how to activate this. Again, you'll go to the settings, and you're gonna scroll down until you get to phone. So we're gonna click on phone right here, and then I'm just gonna scroll down, and you can see that you have this option to silence unknown callers. Now, by default, this is turned off. You can see I already turned mine on. But what you wanna do is enable this feature, silence unknown callers. That way, anybody who's calling from an unknown phone number, like telemarketers, scammers, spammers, you automatically silence them so that you don't have to deal with all those robocalls anymore. So remember, by default, this is turned off. You wanna go into your settings, phone, and then turn on silence unknown callers. That way your phone doesn't keep getting blown up by all of these telemarketing messages. Now, you guys are learning something new, finding these iPhone 11 hidden features valuable. Be sure to hit that like button and share it with your friends, especially since you want your friends not to have to deal with telemarketers or spammers as well. And we're also showing off some other hidden features I think they'll enjoy. But be sure to hit like, and let's take a look at the next hidden feature. This next hidden feature could help you save your battery life long-term on your iOS 13 device. So what you're gonna wanna do is go into settings. You're gonna scroll down until you see battery right here. And then you can see that we have battery health as an option. So you click on battery health. Now you'll see that there's this option right here, optimize battery charging. Now what this does is your iPhone will automatically detect when you typically charge your phone, when you take your phone off the charger, so it'll only charge that last 20% of your battery right before you need it, right? Because the problem is, let's say you're charging your phone all night and it keeps charging throughout the night, the problem is it'll get to 100% really quickly and then it'll keep charging or it'll already be at 100. That could harm the long-term life of the battery. You only wanna charge it to 100% when you're gonna take it off the charger right away. So that's what this does automatically, is it will optimize the battery charging that you have, so that way it will automatically finish off charging right before you need to take your iPhone off the dock. So definitely enable this optimize battery charging right there in battery, battery health, optimize battery charging. Sometimes you're getting close to your data limit and you wanna make sure that you don't have these apps in the background using up all of your data. Right? And you know that sometimes you open the wrong app, it downloads a ton of data, it just kills your limit. And even if you have unlimited, let's say you're traveling abroad, and this is something I run into, I'm traveling abroad, and then you have a very limited amount of data that you can use, even if you have unlimited back where you live, you run into these issues where you could use up that data very quickly, especially if you're used to unlimited. So there is a new hidden feature right here in your iPhone running iOS 13 where you're gonna be able to actually activate a low data mode. That's gonna help you conserve data, especially when you're reaching a limit or if you're traveling abroad. So here's what you could do. You go into the settings application, you click on cellular right here, and then you can see at the top we have cellular data options. And then you could see that we have this option right here, low data mode. So this is gonna help you reduce the network data use that you use, turn that on in order to activate low data mode and help conserve your data so you don't hit those limits. If you're like me, you probably have a lot of tabs open in Safari. You open it up, you see all the way back, all these sites you visited a long time ago, and it's just a pain to click that XXXXX, kind of purge it all out, get rid of, you know, all the pages that you had open from a long time ago. So what if you had the ability to automatically have your iPhone purge pages you haven't looked at in a week or a month? Well, now there's a feature for that. So you can actually go into the settings, and then scroll down until you see Safari, which is right here, Safari. And then if we scroll down, you'll see that we have closed tabs, and right now it's manually, right? So we go in, we have to hit the X on all the other tabs. Again, if you're like me, you probably have a lot of tabs open, and you just don't really get around to closing them, and then every once in a while you do a huge purge, and you have like 100 tabs, you're closing them. Well, what you can do is if you click on here, instead of manually, you can have it purge after a week, a month, or a day. I don't really recommend a day unless you really just wanna keep everything clean, because I might wanna go back and see something I was, you know, browsing or looking at, but a week or a month, this is a good feature to have it automatically purge those tabs you aren't looking at anymore, keep it nice and clean in the background right there in Safari. Next, we have two hidden features that will change the way you type on your iPhone. So the first is Quick Path, which actually allows you to swipe in order to type on your iPhone. We'll show you how that works in a second. And then the second is how to activate the hidden trackpad that you can use in order to change the way that you go back and edit things that you're typing. This is a great hidden feature. We're gonna show you how to use both of these. So the first one is Quick Path, where all you have to do is swipe around your keyboard in order to type out words. Now, Android phones have had this for a while, but it is now right here on iOS 13 in Quick Path. So as you can see, all you have to do is swipe over. You can see I just typed hello. Swipe over the keys that you want to do. Just swipe like so, and you can swipe to create words. That will make it much more easy and faster to type on the go, typing really quick just by swiping. Now, the other hidden feature we have, and this is incredible, is the hidden trackpad. Now, imagine how annoying it is, and you guys probably know how annoying it is, just trying to use the magnifying glass, trying to find the exact spot that you want to select on the screen. Well, now there is a hidden trackpad built right into your keyboard that we're going to show you how to access. So, this hidden trackpad, all you have to do is press and hold on the space bar, and as you can see, you can actually move a cursor around the screen to choose exactly where you want it to go. That way, if you have a certain part of a word that you need to change or edit, you can easily reach it just by pressing and holding the space bar and then using the hidden trackpad right here on your keyboard. This is a great hidden feature that's going to make your life so much easier when you're typing. Now, one other thing I wanted to show you is iOS 13 does make it so much easier in order to select words or sentences to cut, paste, remove. So let's say you wanted to select a specific word, just double tap on it. You can select a word, triple tap for a sentence, and then you can actually quadruple tap to select a whole paragraph. So that's another great way to interact with text right here on your iPhone running iOS 13. I hope you guys are enjoying our video on the best iPhone 11 hidden features. Don't worry, we have many more coming up in just a second. But first, I wanted to show you an incredible app that you can use to earn cash back anytime you shop on your iPhone. It's incredible. You can earn cash back, and we'll show you how you can get a $10 bonus just for signing up. They're a sponsor of this video, and we're gonna show you exactly how you can get this right now. So now I'm gonna show you this incredible app that you can use to earn cash back and rewards whenever you're shopping online. And we're gonna give you our special link that you can use to get a $10 bonus just for signing up. So you're gonna wanna follow along and go to this URL. It's bit.ly/getEBATES bonus, just like this, bit.ly/getEBATES bonus, bit.ly/getEBATES bonus, right here on the screen and also down there in the description. Click go, and as you can see here, you're gonna get $10 when you sign up and just make your first purchase with Ebates. Now, it's now called Rakuten, right? But it's the same thing as Ebates. So it's Rakuten Ebates. So this is what you're gonna wanna sign up for. And so you're just gonna put in your email, password, click join now, and that's gonna qualify you to get that $10 reward. So we're gonna do that real quick and show you inside of the app. So once you open up the app, you can see that it is Ebates Rakuten. So you can see right here, they did rebrand a little bit. So they used to be called Ebates, now they're Rakuten. But you can go through and take a look and see here that you're able to shop at a variety of different stores and earn cash back, like Macy's, Ralph Lauren, Under Armour, Newegg, Amazon, Walmart. Now, Amazon isn't always the case, so be careful because sometimes there's different categories, but Walmart, Dick's Sporting Goods, right? Groupon, Old Navy, you know, eBay, Gap, Best Buy, a wide variety of places you're shopping online. Kohl's, look at this, Kohl's, 12% cash back. Imagine if you were just shopping on Kohl's already. If you're not using this app, you're missing out on 12% cash back that you can use from Rakuten Ebates. So you can see here, you can actually get that 12% cash back. Now, if you scroll through, you'll also notice that it tells you about coupons, like take $10 off, 15% off, $10 off, you know, certain orders. You can see here, it'll give you the coupon codes as well. So you can actually stack coupons and cash back. And it's as simple as this to earn cash back. Just click shop now. As you can see, 12% activated. And then you can see that it pops up right here. And as you can see, this is Kohl's. And you can see at the top, 12% cash back activated. You can also click on 7 deals. You can copy coupon codes that are available too. So you can stack coupon codes and cash back that you get from this application. Now, the extra benefit, another thing that you can stack on top of this, and there's a wide variety of different stores. Macy's is one of my favorites to use this at. As you can see, 6% cash back, and it shows you coupons as well. Once you download this app by going to bit.ly/getEbatesBonus, it's right here on the screen and in the description, you'll get a $10 bonus once you spend $25 at any of these stores within 90 days. So you have some time to go in and spend money at any of these stores, just $25, you'll get the cash back, and because you used the link, bit.ly/getEbatesBonus, you will also get a $10 gift card. So I highly recommend taking a look here. You can see there's a wide variety of different stores that you can shop at. I mean, look at this, right? If you're gonna shop at Kohl's already, you can see hotels.com, Priceline, GameStop. There's a wide variety of different places you can shop online at and earn cash back. So I highly recommend going to bit.ly/getEbatesBonus to get your $10 bonus and earn cash back whenever you shop. The next hidden feature we have is a little more serious, and I hope that no one watching this ever has to use this, but I wanted to make sure that I showed you this in this video. It's called Emergency SOS, and I highly encourage everybody watching this video to install this, also to let other people know about this feature as well, because this could save your life in a dangerous situation. Again, hopefully nobody watching this has to use this, but I wanted to make sure that I showed everyone on this video how this works. So what you want to do is go into the settings application, and then you're going to scroll down to Emergency SOS right here, Emergency SOS. Now by default, if you press and hold on the side button and the volume up button, or actually either of the volume buttons at the same time, you know that that will pop up with the ability to turn off your phone or Emergency SOS. And if you actually keep pressing and holding one of the volume buttons and the side button, it will automatically activate Emergency SOS and call emergency services. But what you may not know, and what I highly encourage all of you to activate, is there's also an easier way to activate Emergency SOS that I recommend doing. You can do it much more discreetly than pressing and holding two different buttons, and it is the call with side button. This is what I encourage all of you to enable right now by going into settings, going into Emergency SOS, and then enable this option, call with side button. What this does is it allows you to automatically activate emergency services. So it'll call 911. It will also notify your emergency contacts, which we'll show you how to set up in just a second, in the event of an emergency. Again, hopefully you never have to use this, but it's better to be safe than sorry. So I recommend going into your settings, Emergency SOS, activating the call with side button. And so now you still have the ability to press and hold on the side button and one of the volume buttons, and it will call emergency service. You hold it long enough. But now you have a quicker and simpler and more discreet way that you could do, even just holding your phone in your pocket. You can press this button right here, the side button, 5 times in quick succession. So press this 5 times and it will automatically call emergency services. So I highly recommend everybody watching this to go and activate this feature. And then the next thing that you will want to do is click on set up emergency contacts and health. When you click on that, it will bring you into the health app, and you can actually put in the name, email, and phone number of your emergency contacts, and they'll also be notified if you activate Emergency SOS. It will notify them, let them know that you are in some type of situation. So again, hopefully you never ever have to use this, but I wanted to make sure that I showed this on this video because this is a hidden feature that could save your life. And I recommend also letting other people know about this feature as well. Now I want to show you a really cool hidden feature, how to add a virtual home button right here on your iPhone. Now, obviously, you know, ever since the last few iPhones, there hasn't been a physical home button. But would you like to add your own virtual home button right here at the bottom of your device, like so? As you can see, it starts to fade away when you're not pressing it. That's a virtual home button. As you can see, if we turn the phone off, the home button is right there. If we swipe up, we access the phone, it's still there. And what this allows you to do is when you press it, not just be able to use it as a regular home button, but you can actually activate Siri, you can activate different features on your device, look at notifications, open up the control center, just like so from this virtual home button. Just like that. Isn't that cool? So that's what I want to show you how to do right here in this hidden feature. I'm going to show you how to activate your virtual home button right here on your iPhone. So now I'm going to show you how you can get the secret virtual home button right here on your iPhone. Now, as you can see, the home button's not there right now. And that's because this is the way your iPhone probably looks, right? It doesn't have it by default. You have to enable it in the settings. So you open up the settings app, and then you scroll down until you see accessibility right there, accessibility. Then you click on accessibility, and then you see that we have physical and motor, and you see we have touch. So you choose touch, and then at the top, you go to assistive touch, and then you enable assistive touch. And look at that, right there is your virtual home button. It pops up right on the screen. It's incredible. So as you can see, if you press this virtual home button, you can not only be able to go home and exit out of the apps, right, and treat it as a home button, you can also access the control center like so. You can access notifications, even access Siri, right? And you can customize it, which we'll show you how to do in a second. Now, let's say you don't like the positioning right there. You can press and hold on it and actually drag it somewhere else. Like you could drag it over to the side. That's a common place for it as well. But I like to drag it right down here, right where the home button would be. And that basically makes it your own virtual home button. So you probably already know that you can take a screenshot on your iPhone by pressing the volume up and then also the side button at the same time. As you can see, it gets a screenshot. What most people will do is they'll say, okay, great, I've got a screenshot. They'll swipe it off, you know, and then it appears in the photos. But with iOS 13, there is a new amazing hidden feature when you're taking screenshots in Safari, right? So if you press those buttons again, the volume up and side button to take a screenshot, and then you tap on the screenshot, not only can you make some edits, make some changes, you know, you can draw on it, like point little arrows, there's this new hidden feature right at the top where it says full page. Let's say you wanted to take screenshots of a page that you're viewing on Safari or maybe an article or whatever it happens to be. Instead of doing a screenshot, scrolling down screenshot, you can actually just go in here and choose full page, and now it will actually capture the entire web page you're looking at, right? So you could do this whether you're taking a screenshot of an article or taking a screenshot of any site that you're browsing online. It's very easy in just a couple of taps to take a screenshot of the entire page, which is a really great feature. Instead of having to screenshot, scroll down, you can now take it of the entire page. Just click done, and it'll add it either as a PDF right here in your files. Thanks for watching our video on the best hidden features for your brand new iPhone 11 or iPhone 11 Pro. Hopefully you learned some new